This tutorial demonstrates how to test generic units. The application under test is a simple calculator. For each kind of operation, on each kind of operand, there exists a dedicated arithmetic logic unit, or ALU. To implement the calculator sounds like a lot of work and duplication of effort, because a calculator with four binary operators and two operand types would require eight ALUs. However, because the algorithm is common, we can instantiate each ALU from a generic unit by specifying parameters. If the generic unit contains unit tests, then each ALU obtains these as well. A generic unit is like a parameterized template. Therefore, given the chain of packages shown here, we can instantiate all the required addition packages using parameters. So in the case, we can instantiate the addition arithmetic logic unit by providing the class int and the function addition. We can instantiate the test case for addition by supplying an initialize procedure, and also the test suite for addition test by providing an identifier string. Okay, let's take a look at the code. In this package, which was introduced in part one of the tutorial, all binary operations on scalar types use the same algorithm so as to enable code reuse across all instances. Here are the formal generic parameters, which accept an operand object and an operation function. Here we create a subclass of operation to represent an ALU. And each ALU has only one public method, namely execute. In the private part of the specification, we declare the ALU register attributes and the methods on the type. Stack pair to ALU and ALU result to stack. In the body of the generic unit, note that operand could be of any type, integer, float, fixed, and the operation could be addition, subtraction, etc. So we are now in the generic child package, gentest. The unit under test, i.e. the parent of this package, is generic, and therefore its test case must also be generic. To instantiate a concrete test case, the client programmer must provide an initialize procedure. Here we derive a test case class from the test fixture, override setup and teardown procedures, and declare the test case scenarios and the class attributes. Setup, which is called by the framework before each test routine is run, will invoke the initialize procedure to copy the parameters to the attributes of the test case. Note that operand 1, operand 2, and expected result each contain a variable that has been set to some value by the client. Teardown is called by the framework after each test routine is run. Pragma unreference is used here to inform the compiler that objects popped from the stack are no longer referenced. And here's the implementation of the test case scenarios. We are now in the generic suite package. Each ALU needs to compose its tests into a test suite. In preparation for that, we declare subprogram access constants for each test case scenario on the test case class. The ADA access attribute is not allowed in a generic body, therefore we declare the pointers in the specification. In the body of GenSuite, we declare a pointer to the new test suite class. And create and identify each test and then add it to the suite. Here we instantiate addition from binary by specifying the operand object int and the operation function addition that works with int objects. Here we instantiate the test case for addition. It's interesting to note that because binary has a child package, gentest, addition obtains that package as well. However, a file corresponding to the package operations.addition.gentest does not exist. This virtual package becomes available after the instantiation of operations.addition. However, the formal subprogram parameter initialize does exist and looks like this. Here we supply an operation object capable of performing addition on integers and integer operands set to specific values. So here we have 4 plus 6, the expected value. And in this package here, we instantiate the test suite from the virtual package, operations.addition.test.gensuite. The generic parameter is simply a string to identify the ALU in question. So the process in general is such that addition comes from binary, test comes from gentest, and suite comes from gensuite. Fixed array scene, and the same process applies to subtraction, same procedure. Test client we have seen, works like an RPN calculator. And as a reminder, here's our collection of operations on int objects. These functions represent one of the actual parameters in the specification of the generic package binary. And also as a reminder, here's the int class, which is specialized to work with integers. So if we compile and run the test cases, we'll run this with GNAT coverage. And here's the output. Total 14 tests ran, and all the tests were successful.